Hello everybody, this is Dr. Monica, Assistant Professor of Zoology in Government College, Bahadurgarh, Haryana. Welcome to my online lecture, and the topic of today's online lecture is Aristotle's lantern. What is Aristotle's lantern and why do we call it so? Now, Aristotle's lantern was first described in Historia Animalium by Aristotle when he was studying the mouth parts of sea urchin. He called the structure a horn lantern based upon its morphology and the texture of the components. Later on, this structure was also called Aristotle's lantern by other scientists who studied it in greater details and in honor of the legend. Now, what it is? It is basically a jaw apparatus which is used for scraping of food material and eating. Now, it is composed of a complex set of circumpharyngeal ossicles and muscles. The significance lies in the fact that it is a protrusible structure which is used for various activities during feeding, such as scraping, grasping, pulling, and tearing at the algae or the food material that they eat. Now, the detailed structure of Aristotle's lantern shows various components, and it basically encloses the buccal cavity and the pharynx. The overall structure looks like as is given in this diagram. We see here the test or the shell of the sea urchin, and this is the oral end. At the oral end, this is how the entire Aristotle's lantern is located. Here we see the extensions of the shell, which are called as auricle, and they assist in its function by being a site of attachment of the retractor muscle. Then we have these inverted pyramids that we are going to cover in the next slide. So these ossicles are called as pyramids, and they are triangular and inverted in shape, and they are attached to the auricle by protractor muscle. Now, the axis of the lantern is hollow and formed by the pharynx. So the pharynx is here in the interior, and the esophagus is going to project out of the Aristotle's lantern and be a part of the digestive system. Now, the body of the lantern is a pentamerous apparatus that consists of many ossicles with different shapes and sizes, each suited for a particular role in the functioning of the jaw apparatus. Looking at the detailed structure, again, we see that it consists of approximately 40 different ossicles which are connected together by more than 60 bands or muscles of specialized ligaments. Now, the major ossicles are, you know, the pyramids that we talked about. There are five large calcareous arrowhead shaped plates, each pointing towards the mouth. So here we have this pyramid. Now, along the inner side of each pyramid is a long calcareous tooth band. Its upper end is enclosed in a dental sac and projects on the oral end as hard tooth. So here we see all the teeth. Since there is one tooth band for each pyramid, we have five such teeth. Now, the middle portion of the tooth is actually enclosed between two halves of an ossicle, which is called as alveolus. And the horn-like processes of the alveoli, or singular alveolus, actually are separate ossicles in themselves, but they are fused. Then five ossicles called the rotulae radiate from the middle of the lantern, as we see here. So this is one rotula. Below the rotulae and also radial in position are compasses. Now this is a compass here. So we have them as Y-shaped bones or ossicles, and five ridges or auricles, which are a part of the shell that we saw here, they complete the entire structure. Now, looking at the function of Aristotle's lantern, we must first talk about the various muscles and ligaments which are attached to all these numerous ossicles. And the lantern can be partially protracted and retracted through the mouth or the oral sinus by means of special protractor and retractor muscles, like we saw in the previous slides. Other specialized muscles, like the 5 interpyramidal muscles, control the opening and the closing of the teeth. The compass elevator muscles connect the 5 compasses, and the compass depressor muscles basically connect the compasses to the shell. And here we see that I have taken a few snapshots from a video for which the link has been given onto the slide, and I recommend that all of you should watch it. Here we see, let us go in the reverse order. Now this is the mouth, which is, you know, the teeth are totally separated out, right? And this is semi-open mouth, and this is closed arrangement of the teeth, right? So basically, when the mouth is closed and the teeth are all together, we see that there is slight overlapping of the teeth. Now the teeth open with the concerted efforts of the muscles and various ossicles in such a manner that on opening, the teeth project out of the cavity. They are actually protruding, and they scrape off the algae, and then they take it back in this motion, right? So a continuous motion of these 3 frames will bring about scraping up of the algae or the food material and taking it in the pharynx and then ultimately the digestive system. Now, the references for the entire presentation that you saw here are various textbooks of invertebrate zoology, particularly Robert Hegner, then Rupert and Barnes, and Kotpal. Now, this video is an excellent source of understanding the functioning of Aristotle's lantern, and I would really recommend you to look at it and appreciate. Then another research paper by Pinotrugo from the Department of Design and Industry, San Francisco State University. This paper describes a model, biomimicked model of Giorgio Scarpa, who studied the Aristotle's lantern and made a wooden model out of it and showed its functioning. And then he utilized it in various other fields so as to utilize the design, biodesign, and help in making more machines out of it. So I hope you liked my lecture. And your feedbacks are welcome. Kindly visit my YouTube channel for your feedbacks. Thank you very much.